हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ मी सौरव अवस्थी, इंग्लिश फैकल्टी ऑफ माउंट लिट्रा जी स्कूल झांसी। एंड टुडे आई हैव ब्रॉट अ न्यू चैप्टर फॉर यू, दैट इज शुड विजार्ड हिट मॉमी, विच इज अ लेक्चर नंबर 1। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट फर्स्ट हाफ ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, इन विच यू विल कम टू नो दैट हु इज this Roger Scrum. So before that, let's start with the introduction of the author. John Updike, in full John Hoyer Updike, born on March 18, 1932, reading in Pennsylvania, US, died January 27, 2009, Danvers, Massachusetts. American writer of novels, short stories and poetry, known for his careful craftsmanship and realistic but subtle depiction of American Protestant small town middle class life. So this was the introduction of the author. Now let's discuss about his chapter, in where he have shown that how that parents used to think for their children. So here in this chapter we will have the world view of a little child and the difficult moral question she raises during the story session with her father. Because actually students, what used to happen, children used to think according to their experience. But here, on the another side, parents use their own experience which they have for their children and also for the benefit of their children. So here let's study that what happened in the story. So let's continue now. In the evening and for Saturday naps like today's, Jack told his daughter Joe a story out of his head. This custom began when she was of 2 years, was itself now nearly 2 years old, and his head felt empty. So now students, this was actually the custom which was being made by her father, who always used to come from his office, and at night he used to tell stories to his daughter. So here each new story was a slight variation of a basic tale. A small creature usually named Roger. So students, it can be like Roger Fish, Roger Squirrel or Roger Chipmunk. It can be any animal, that means from the jungle, or any creature who will have the same name which will start with Roger. Had some problem and went with it to the wise old owl. The owl told him to go to the wizard, and the wizard performed a magic spell that solved the problem, demanding in payment a number of pennies greater than the number that Roger creature had. But in the same breath, directing the animal to a place where he can get the extra pennies which he could find over there. So like this, that means there was a wizard, a magician, who is going to change everything in the life of Roger Scrum. So now, then Roger was so happy, he played many games with other creatures and went home to his mother just in time to hear the train whistle that brought his daddy home from Boston. Jack described their supper and the story was over. So finally, that means what is going to happen in the story? Let's see. Working his way through this scheme was especially fatiguing on Saturday, because Joe never fell asleep in naps anymore, and knowing this made the ride seem futile. The little girl not so little anymore. The bumps her feet made under the covers were halfway down the bed, their big double bed that they let her be in for naps, and when she was sick, had at last arranged herself, and from the way her fat face deep in the pillows shone in the sunlight sifting through the drawn shades, it did not seem fantastic that some magic would occur and she would take her nap like an infant of two. Her brother Bobby was two and already asleep with his bottle. Jack asked, "Who shall the story be about today?" So finally, students, now like this, that means this was the introduction of the story, when her father, that means, came from the office and he was tired, but still he was thinking that this girl may go for a sleep, but still this girl was not taking a nap and she was waiting for her father so that he may come and he may start explaining this story. So now what is going to be there in the story? We are starting from here. Once upon a time, in the deep dark woods, there was a tiny little creature by the name of Roger Skunk, and he smelled very bad. Yes, Joe said he smelled so bad that none of the other little woodland creatures would play with him. Joe looked at him solemnly. She hadn't foreseen this. As whenever he would go out to play, Jack continued with jest, remembering certain humiliations of his own childhood. All of the other tiny animals would cry, "Oh, oh, here comes Roger Stinky Skunk," and they would run away, and Roger Skunk would stand there all alone, and two little round tears would fall from his eyes. And the corners of Joe's mouth dropped down and her lower lip went forward as he traced with a forefinger along the side of her nose the course of one of Roger Skunk's tears. "Won't he see the owl?" she asked in a high and faintly roughened voice. Sitting on the bed beside her, Jack felt the covers tug as her legs swished tensely. So finally, students, here you can just understand that now the curiosity was there in a girl who want to know that why all these things were happening and why this creature have not reached to old wise owl up till now. So now the story continues. He was pleased with this moment. He was telling her something true, something she must know, and had no wish to hurry on. But downstairs, a chair scraped, and he realized he must get down to help clear paint the living room woodwork. Well, he walked along very sadly and came to a very big tree, and in the tip top of the tree was an enormous wise old owl. So finally, this creature have reached to the tree where old wise owl was living. "Good, Mr. Owl," Roger Skunk said. "All the other little animals run away from me because I smell so bad." "So you do," the owl said. "Very, very bad. What can I do?" Roger Skunk said, and he cried very hard. So now the old wise owl is going to reply. "The wizard, the wizard," Joe shouted and sat right up, and a little golden book spilled from the bed. So here you can see, students, that how Joe became excited now to hear that what old wise owl have suggested about the wizard, that wizard, what he is going to do. Now, Joe Daddy is telling the story. Do you want to tell daddy the story? No, you me. Then lie down and be sleepy. Her head relapsed onto the pillow and she said, out of your head. Well, the owl thought and thought. At last he said, why don't you go see the wizard? Daddy, what? Are magic spells real? This was a new face just this last month, a reality face. So the conversation is still going on between a girl and a father, where the story is that when he told her spiders eat bugs, she turned to her mother and asked, do they really? And when Claire told her God was in the sky and all around them, she turned to her father and insisted with a sly yet eager smile, is he really? They are real in stories. Jack answered curtly. She had made him miss a beat in the narrative. So right now, as the father was narrating a story, she was speaking in between again and again just because of the curiosity and excitement which she was having while listening that story about Roger Skunk, who is used to smell very badly. That's why he was unhappy, he was sad, due to which he reached to the old wise owl, where he was suggested to reach the wizard. So finally, that Roger Skunk is going to move into the deep jungle, deep forest, where he is going to find that wizard who used to live over there in the middle of the jungle, where river was also there just near his house, as well as a well was also there, which was very old. And from there only, this skunk is going to get the remaining pennies, which he is going to give to that wizard. So all these things we will discuss in the next part of the video of this chapter, Should Wizard Hit Mommy? Till then, stay healthy, stay safe, and stay at home. Thank you so much.